So I think we're where we're going to be.
Hey, should I show you what I bought? Okay, so check it out. All right.
Until next time.
Adrian is awesome. So, okay, so Inigo, I didn't do anything with Inigo. But I bought stuff for me. So I bought all the Bosmer heavy stuff. So I got the Bosmer heavy coif, so I got rid of that stupid horned helmet that I wasn't a fan of, even though, like, is stereotypical Skyrim, excuse me. Now, you know, it looks... It doesn't look like it matches at all. Yes.
He's a steward up at Dragon's Reach.
He just paid me $100 for killing a ton of dudes. Anyway, but I also got the Bosmer boots, too, since they're heavy. And they were better than the Nordmail boots, so we were completely done with the Nordmail stuff. And now I'm kind of a mixed match, but I think the color scheme actually matches fairly well. Also, notice the sword. I got rid of the cutlass. Because the Forsworn sword I picked up, when modified just to fine, is 24 damage versus 20. Whereas the cutlass at fine was 20, and I don't have enough points in blacksmithing. But that's one thing I did. I got myself at least a 20. And then I just realized that you can't get training from what's-his-face up at the Skyforge without doing any of the companion stuff first, and I don't want to do that yet. So we're as good as we can be, but, I mean, if we look at... Do I have a level I have to... No, I'm close, but I don't have a level yet.
I work with my mother to sell fruits and vegetables. It's fun most days, but hard work.
You better run! Okay, so if we go to items... 299 versus 355. So I got rid of a bunch of junk. Basically. And now we can go kill the Thalmor. Also, too, I did improve all of Inigo's stuff, so...
What can I do for you?
Let me show off your stuff.
What is yours is mine.
Sure. So I got all these up to fine. So now I at least improved them all. So I got improvement that way.
What's next?
We're going to kill the Thalmor. So we're going to kill the Thalmor. More. Right. Anyway. Let's see. Okay, we tried. Let's see. Deliver proof to Alvelstein. Find a way to... Yeah. I wish it was an optional part of it, but... Talking to General Tullius is not required. Oh, not required. I'm sorry, I keep hitting the desk. So you're probably hearing all this... Wah, 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 wah. That's my... The boom. Hang on. There we go. Hopefully that's not so bad. So, let's go punch him in the teeth. First, let's save my game. Also, too, why didn't anybody tell me I didn't have my FOV all screwed up? I've been doing that. I've been playing that way for about 15, 20 minutes now. No one said anything. Really? I'm giving you guys all crap. I am. Yeah. I'm gonna have to remount it, I think. Anyway, okay, so we'll do... What is today? 7th. So, 0, 0, 7, 17. Boom. There we go. Let's go to it. So, we have to get up to where? All the way up there. Yep. Okay, so the easiest way, let's hit Meridia. And then we'll go around and up. I was gonna say, that sounds rather, I can't think of the word. Suggestive. Why did I feel like there was somebody up here that I missed? What is this? Maybe I... Sorry, I swear I thought I saw another Thalmor patrol, so I was getting all jazzed up to beat them. Okay, so where are we right now? Something just froze and released. The video didn't change. Where am I? I'm going the right way. What's that? Ironback Hideout? That's a hell of a name. Do we dare go discover it, or is it going to be a pain in the butt? I think it's going to be a pain in the butt. Let's follow the path around the side. Oh, and we should see. Wet and cold should have us. Yep. We're cold. Man, this is freezing. And here, but I bought a Bosmer coif, so at least it has some fabric in it, so it's not so cold. And Inigo's got all of his Red Guard stuff, but it's probably not very... It's good thing he's got fur. I'll put it that way. What's this? This is something. What is this? I want to find out what this is. I want to know what this is. What is this? Wolf Skull Cave. Okay. Good. Sounds like something out of Star Trek. Running and running and running and running. There's something else I was gonna say too, and I don't remember what it was. Oh, the snow stopped. We ran through it. It's a big stone precipice. Jeez. Okay, where are we? Nope. I'm getting distracted. So I look kind of goofy, don't I? Steel armor, Bosmer stuff, and then I've got that Forsworn sword hanging from my belt. Kind of excited about it, though. I've always thought they were kind of cool. And, yeah. Maybe Katsuragi thinks that there's something very primitive. Not primitive, but very noble. No, that's still discriminatory and savage. Maybe it's something very essential about the warfare of the Forsworn that he appreciates. I was thinking a lot about his backstory, what it could possibly be. I mean, I keep talking about the fact, I keep thinking he's got, you know, Akaviri in his bloodline, and, you know, his... Ah, that's the phrase. Okay. You know that his father was Akaviri, theoretically, or not Akaviri, but I mean that bloodline or whatever, and however they ended up that way, right? And that his son possibly was the gentleman that we found, you know, thanks to Live Another Life, that was burned to a crisp and had the journal there. So if we wrap it in together, I was also thinking too that his father, while they were living in Cyrodiil, since, well, oh, hi. I'd like to think I helped. What was I gonna say? I'd like to think maybe his father was... Because, okay, spoiler alert. If you are a new player to Skyrim, plug your ears right now. So, good. That the blades essentially come from the Akaviri, right? So then maybe his father went to join the blades because of that connection. And maybe he was one of the guards that died protecting the Emperor. But I don't think that'll work. As far as, and of course this isn't serious, but I don't think that would work because I think there's too much time that's passed between now and Oblivion. But it was an idea. So, but either way, it's just, that's one of the things that, I was talking with a friend of mine about this, who's actually been watching this, that having some sort of, I mean, role-playing a Let's Play is a double-edged sword, for lack of a better term, and the way I do it, as you see, is very fluid, very informal. I play more like I'm watching a book, right? Like I'm reading a book, the character's in my head, but really we're not reading a book and I'm playing the character. But some people do it very seriously, and that's fine, and they do a very good job, but there's something about that where either way, creating some backstory for it before you begin, even a game like Skyrim, can do nothing but help you. And the reason I say that is because it's such a wide-ranging game, it's easy to get bored. And what I mean by that is that there's so much to do, you can get locked into the same thing every time because you don't know what to explore, and if you don't have the motivation to explore anymore, you won't. But if you're role-playing it, and what I mean by role-play, isn't that the easier way down? It is. I'm not going to take it, though. it will make you do certain decisions that you might not normally do, and it possibly could force you out of your comfort zone, or at least make you feel like you have purpose. And with a game like this, where there is such an overarching story but so many side plots, having that purpose, I think, makes the gameplay more meaningful. Hence, more fun. And so, playing Katsuragi, once I finally figured out what he was, I had already done a playthrough with a character called Katsuragi. It was the same Katsuragi! What? No. And I had Inigo and everything else. And that was when I decided that I wanted to become a brutal bastard. No, that I decided I wanted to do a Let's Play because I found a character I sculpted that I think I could use that'd be fun. And that's kind of where it came from. And there's that. No, I want to go over there. I do. I shouldn't. Inigo, should we go over there? They're going to want to kill us. It's another quest. Yeah, we better go over there. Speaking of Skyrim, what would Katsuragi do? Okay, so here we go. What would Katsuragi do? Katsuragi would look over there and see nothing, really. He sees people. I know there's a quest over there. I know there's a boat over there. He doesn't care about exploration right now. He's thinking about the Thalmor have an execution order. They have a threat on his life. He's pissed. There's dragons in the area. And he took he made a promise that he would take care of this Thalmor issue and bring Thorald home. So that's what Katsuragi would do. He doesn't give a damn about that shit. He's gonna go over here, kick some ass, and that's what we're gonna do. See? Roleplay. Easy enough. Okay, don't disturb the Harkers. Don't disturb the Harkers. Nope, we're not disturbing any Harkers. Don't run out. Well, they can't really run. Poor bastards. The music is working, isn't it? I like it. I haven't really noticed much of a difference. It's just been really fluid and adds very well. Lower steep fall burrow. We may.
Smells troublesome. It may be a good idea to ready our weapons.
We'll be okay so far, but yeah, it's just horkers. But if we go in there, yes, you're right. We will have to ready our weapons. Wouldn't it be awesome if those were just big cuddly walruses? And every time you ran into horkers, you'd be like, oh, horkers! But, oh, really? Are you freaking kidding me? Oh, Inigo! Ow. Is there another one? Really? There's two? Inigo, are you feeling okay? You're being awfully fatalistic lately. Where is the... I think we're okay. We're gonna have to have a talk after we're done with the Thalmor, because, yes, I do realize he's got the little bit more left of his story that I haven't entirely completed, but, dude. Oh, there it is. That's what I was looking for, right there. So what if it's floating in the air? Don't question Skyrim. Skyrim questions you as well. In Russia. Wait, no, that joke doesn't work. Anyway. Stop vibrating, please. Wow. Trying to make sure that the microphone doesn't go crazy. I'm hoping that isn't really intrusive. I apologize if it is. It's easy to get really annoyed at stuff like that. I get annoyed at it all the time with other Let's Plays. I'm probably just as guilty. Okay, so here we are. So let's just step back and admire the efficient beauty of elven barricades and military industrial complex. So hang on a second. I'll be right back. Alright. Let's go hold them accountable for Thorald, shall we? Excuse me. Here you go. You ready for this? Oh, I did favorite it. Good for me. Wait. Nope. Nope. Do that. Do that. Do that. Do that. There we go. I'd like to see my face. Okay, not quite that long of a walk up.
Hey, watch what you're doing. Halt!
I'm here for Thorald Greymane.
Are you joking? Even if we had a prisoner by that name, the only way he'd be released is by order of the Imperial Legion. Now I suggest you turn around and go back the way you came.
What is this place?
That's privileged information. Now, move along.
Move along, huh? Move along. Let's move along. We're gonna move along, right? Move along my ass!
What's that? Wrong!
No kidding. No. Bad. Haven't we talked to you about doing that? I didn't even have it on. Oh, you know what? This is Dwemer. How do you feel about being owned? Just in case we have some issues. Let's just do... Oh, did I mention I also made a ton of healing potions? I probably didn't. Eat Forsworn Sword! Did we? Are they all dead? Not a bad run. Let's loot some bodies, shall we? Let's see. I'll take those. I don't need that. Yeah, the rest of you, what you've got is garbage. Garbage. It's a pretty good little battle. If I do say so myself. Oh, an Alanor Saber. We are taking those suckers. Because those, I think, are better. Even what I've got right now, the Forsworn Sword, is still not as good as what I've got. Or as those. What have you? What's your deal? Elven armor. That's light armor. Isn't there heavy elven armor, though, too? Maybe there isn't. Gold. Really? Ooh! An elven steel sword. Which has damage 24. Are you kidding me? Really? Alright. Guess we'll take it. But that's what my Forsworn sword does have right now. What? Okay, let's take a look at weapons. Wow, 22. Improved those once, and that's pretty good. So if we find any place to improve it inside, I think we'll switch to it. But, in the meantime, we'll save our game here. Alright. Inigo. Inigo. Ow! Jeez! Sorry. Sorry. My knee hit the desk.
Ruby, you okay?
Ruby's sitting in here. My dog. She's the cutest puppy on the face of the planet. Guess you will eventually be able to see her. I promise. Just not today. Why? I don't know. Maybe. Okay. Oh, hi! How are you? You don't see me. Are you kidding? Wow. That was some Mario Kart action right there. That pop up like that. I'm still using ancient Nord arrows. Yes. Garnet. Yes. Yes. Hooded Thalmor robes will pull in 410 gold, huh? Sorry, we're ripping that off of you. All right. Let's switch arrows here, though. I probably have something better, don't I? I've got Inigo's ebony arrows, but that's, I don't know. I don't like using his arrows. I mean, I get it, but I don't really want to if I don't have to. Oh, shoot, I know what I was gonna do. Hang on. Screw, oh, I already have it cranked. Shoot. Yeah, sorry. Guess I will have to do a post-production, like usual. Because I don't have any of the wearable lanterns because I'm an idiot and didn't make any. It's the whole point of having the mod installed, and I'm sorry. Oh well. Hopefully this isn't too bad. Someday I'll learn. Someday I will. I promise. I'll learn. I'm going to take the charcoal. I'll learn, and I will have everything prepared, and everything will look fine and dandy, and there's a gourd. Don't ask questions. Not sure. Oh, chest. That's an odd thing to find here. Studded Imperial armor, huh? Ornal's fate. And the realms of the Daedra. This is the quest. Okay, this is a mod. This is one of the few mods that I installed from the Steam Workshop, because it doesn't exist in the Nexus. We gotta keep this. And we have Realms of the Daedra. That's a great mod. I love it. It's not that complicated, but it's fun. So this is great. Nightingale's Factor Fiction, we already know about them. Find the it's a good mod. It's a really good mod. Black Arrow, I get something out of that, don't I? I already got it. Shoot. Kill before you be killed. Do I get anything from it? No. Damn it. Oh well. Okay, so we're going to open this door. We're going to take this ancient Nord arrow because I missed. We're going to open this door. And then we're going to find our first target. And you know what I never use and I should is poison. You see, this is what happens when you have an execution order against Katsuragi. This is what happens right here. He goes Arnold Schwarzenegger on you in Commando from 1984, I think. And this is what happens. He blows up your entire establishment. Obviously, they didn't take his daughter or anything, but you know the reference. You know what I'm talking about. There we go. So, come here. Let's do this. Let's do that. Good old frostbite venom. Sorry, you're about to have a bad day.
Is someone there?
No, not at all.
Eliminated.
Yep. Sorry. I will take the other ones, though. I will take the steel arrows. So, the poison, really, how many... Well, I guess I'll put it back on again. The poison doesn't work on the bow. It should be... There we go. I was going to say it should be on the arrow. Right? In the neck. Really? Where's your mother? In your face. Thank you. And then hopefully... Good job. All right. We're figuring this out slowly but surely. I am taking all the... Oh, no. I'm carrying too much to run. Damn it. What am I carrying that's too heavy? Besides everything. Don't say anything. The elven steel sword is too heavy. Okay. Huh. So, what's my Forsworn sword like? Oh. It's the same weight. And it's the same... But doesn't cost as much. But it looks cooler. I mean, it looks more... You know what I mean. But I like these too. I guess we'll just give them to Inigo. But you promise you won't use these swords? Well... Okay, hang on.
What is yours is mine.
I know, but... What stuff you would not use? You wouldn't wear that. I hope. We don't need that. We don't need... I'm not giving you the masks, because you'll put those on. Well, let's see. Well, that's enough. Nah, you wouldn't use these. Would you?
I have your back, my friend.
I hope not. Well, and if you... Eh, alright, I'm done. I'm done dithering. I'm done dithering, okay? Well, and this is why I should have a freaking backpack, and I don't yet, because I'm an idiot. Sorry. I'm a moron. There's, like, health potions here, aren't there? Nope, nope, nope. And this is all just... Oh, how dare they drink Nord mead here? Did I really see that? I did. Take your apple pie and shove it! Well, that didn't work at all. Yes! Ah! See? I sort of threw it. I was sort of upset. Okay. Can I take any of these torches? No. Okay. Doop 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 doop. There's many, many ways to do the Thalmor quest, but I think the most vindicating is to just completely burn them down, kind of like what we're doing. But you can be a lot sneakier if you wanted to be. Poor bandit. I'm taking your gold. Trust me, it will go to good use. Alright. We are going to save our game again, though. Just because. My headphones are not fitting as well as I thought they would be today. Okay, here we go. Because we're about... Ooh, hi! If I was smart, I would draw you into this particular hallway, because that would make things easier. Oh, there's nobody there. Good. I still can. Where are you? There you are, right? Oh, jeez. Are you kidding me? No, you're not kidding me.
Over here.
You still don't see me. You know what? I mean, you see me, but do you really see me? I don't think you do. I don't think you see Inigo either. Where's your buddy? Where's your buddy? Oh no, she's gonna lead us into the rest of them. Don't do that! Okay, I guess we're doing this. Oh shoot, Inigo, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You are in big trouble.
Oh, I'm sorry, Inigo. I didn't mean to hit you like that. Wow, that was stupid. Are you kidding me? No. No. No, I don't care. Do not care.